All praise to Jesus and the Holy Spirit, and blessings upon everybody who recognize that our only problem is the continuity problem. Our only problem is the continuity problem. Therefore, our full attention is on this problem and how to resolve it. And in the light of this, I have some extremely good news for everyone. These videos are for those who, of course, are very, very determined that they truly want to resolve the conflict that they feel, the problem that they feel. We do admit that we are, quote unquote, sinners. And let's explain what sinners means. Being a sinner means we are believing in laws which don't exist. Laws of manifestation that don't exist. That is what it means to be a sinner. We believe in time, space, process, and form as laws of manifestation. None of these exist at all. God did not create such laws at all. Neither did we. We have no power to create laws of manifestation. So, because we've been sinners for so long, because we've been desiring appearance to give the impression that these laws exist, we're so used to believing that without these imaginary laws, without these appearances that imply that these exist, we wouldn't exist at all. We would have no being, as if being is dependent on these imaginary laws, time, space, process, and form. So we have a severe continuity problem, meaning we're afraid to realize that those laws don't exist. And because they don't exist at all, everything is completely perfect right now. No fear whatsoever, just pure bliss, happiness, joy, love, freedom, right here, right now, everywhere, always. We're terrified of that, terrified of that. That's our only problem, because actually these laws that we've been pretending exist don't exist at all. So there's nothing we need to do to get rid of them. You see, we don't need to triumph over them. We don't need to transcend them. We don't need to get rid of them. They don't exist. So our only problem is the continuity problem of fully accepting that they don't exist. And how's that feel? How's that feel? So the great good news is that we're getting the right advice. The advice that Jesus gave us is so spot on. What we've done is we have these attitudes, so to speak. It's like hiring actors and actresses. And we tell these actors, actresses to these attitudes, to have this attitude toward us, to make us feel totally unwelcome in reality, totally unwelcome, totally undeserving. For instance, let's say there's a car lot, luxury cars, and you go in there, you say, you know what, it's time for me to have that luxury car I've always wanted. And this represents reality, okay, happiness, all right? Symbolizes happiness, pure happiness. And you go on the car lot, and then imagine the people that work there, the employees, kind of come up to you in this light. Hey, what's going on here? What do you want? What do you want? What's up? What's up? What's happening here? You know? And they treat you like you're not welcome there. Like, who are you? Why are you here? You can't afford these cars. These cars aren't for you. And then they, you know, start spitting on you and mocking you and jeering you and intimidating you to leave. And you say, wow, this is unbelievable. I just came here to get what I really want, and all these employees here are treating me like dirt. They say I don't belong here, I don't deserve it. And I say, what kind of car are you driving now? Oh, you know, implying that I'm in no way fit for this. Well, and then you might get all upset and angry and say, my gosh, God hates me. God doesn't want me here. You know, all, and feel really depressed. But here is the secret. Really, this is the secret of secrets, of all secrets. All of these employees work for us. We hired them. They're actors and actresses. We told them to play this role of mocking and jeering and intimidating us. So we will leave the lot. They work for us. They're our employees. They're doing exactly what we ask them to do. So, with this in mind, here's what we need to do. This, why are they there? Because of the continuity fear. We're terrified. We say, whoa, if I get in that car, I'm going to feel pure happiness. And I'll realize that only pure happiness exists. And I'm totally free. And, you know, we're saying like, oh my God, I don't think I can handle this. I don't think I can handle this. So we hire all these actors and actresses to basically tell us, you can't handle this. You can't handle this. What are you doing here? Get out of here. You know, but they're very snarky and snobbish and just like make you feel like you just don't deserve it at all. We hire them to do this. They're under contract to do this. They're our employees, these attitudes. So what you do is you get on this car lot and you recognize, I have a severe continuity problem. I'm thinking, I don't deserve this. I can't handle it. I understand. So I want to go gradually here, but I do deserve this and I can handle it. I'll be able to, I know. So I'm here. I'm going to stay here. Okay. Now I've got all these snarky employees trying to intimidate me. Fine. You know what I do? I say, thank you. Very good. Very great. Wonderful job, guy. Wonderful job, everybody. That's a wrap. Wonderful job. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, 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 yes. Great, great. You're doing exactly what I hired you to do. Excellent, excellent. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for all your great acting jobs here. You've been impeccable. And you start praising them. And you start, thank you, praising them. Because you're the boss. You hired them. You're the boss. So you have to act like the boss. You have to own the fact you are the boss. You are the boss. These are your attitudes. These are your actors and actresses. These are what you hired. This is part of you. This is an expression to try and protect you from your continuity fears, that you won't be able to function without imaginary laws. So Jesus told us, love your enemy. This is exactly right. Agree with your adversaries. Exactly right. Turn the other cheek. Exactly right. This is the key to salvation. You just stand there and they're spitting on you and say, fantastic. You're doing exactly what I asked you to do. And you've done it so wonderful. And I'm so grateful for all the great service you've done here to intimidate me and scare me, just like I told you to do. But you know what? Now the continuity fear is evaporating very rapidly. And so I'm going to have you play another role, another role. This role is going to make the role of making me feel like I'm a very honored client, totally welcome here. What can we do, sir, first, or ma'am, for you? Yes, look at this one. Let's bring the whole inventory in here. You get to choose whatever you want. We'll get you in exactly what you want. And, you know, just treat you like an absolutely the top client possible. And give them a new role, these attitudes a new role. We are the boss. So it starts with acknowledging and owning the continuity fear, realizing these actors and actresses work for you. These attitudes work for you. You are employing them. We are employing these attitudes. So thank them. Thank them, thank them for their great service. So I'm going to throw a huge party for all of you. All of you have done such a wonderful job. You've been so nasty to me. That is, you just did, you know, I know it was tough for you, but you did it. And I'm so grateful for that. Just love the effort that you put in. And this is called forgiveness. As Jesus says, the key to salvation, forgiveness, forgiveness, forgiveness. Love your enemies. Forgive, 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 forgive. And now I'm seeing it. I'm seeing it in dreams also. And at first you're taken aback, like, whoa, I just came here, you know, because this, I want to repent and return to my functioning, and all these employees are so snarky with me. What the heck? What kind of dealership is God running here? I was thinking like, wow, this is weird. This is horrible. In the dream. And now I realize, oh, yeah. No, they work for me. They work for me. They don't work for God. God is saying, everything I have is yours. You're completely, 100% perfectly loved and welcome here. But we are employing these employees to be snarky to us. God cannot prevent that. Because we would feel attacked, because these employees are protecting us from what we feel is a possible annihilation. Because we believe our existence is based on these imaginary laws. Okay, and we think that we need these laws in order to be. So without these laws, we can't imagine how we could possibly be. If we realize there is no time, space, duration, location, process, or form whatsoever, there has never been and never will be. We feel like, oh my God, I don't have any being, you know, we're terrified of it. So we have all these attitudes to intimidate us away from getting into that vehicle, that light vehicle, as it were, this vehicle of spiritual perception, which will show us, oh my gosh, look at this being that we all are, this one being. They're goons. We've employed these goons. In fact, we told them to act, play the role of goons. So love the goons, as it were. Love your enemy. They're only there because they're there because they're part of us. They're one with us, acting to try and scare us away. You see, from what we deserve, what we truly deserve, from what we are. Okay. Which anything we desire, any experience we desire is, that's what we are. So this revolutionizes the spiritual path, once it's understood. And it brings us to a realization that closure is possible. You see, closure is possible. We don't have to defeat anything. All these non-existent laws don't exist, we don't have to defeat them. The only problem we have is the continuity fear. And these snarky intimidators, we don't have to defeat them either. We have to thank them. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful for everything that you've done for me to scare me off, because that's I was too frightened and I needed this excuse, you know, to be scared off. But now I don't need the excuse. I don't need to be scared off. Maybe for a little while you might just kind of act like kind of impartial, you know, okay. But gradually you start throwing out the welcome wagon, the red carpet, you know, red carpet. Yeah, we want the full red carpet and the lights, the cleat lights, the red carpet, the balloons. And says, wow, here comes our number one customer, the one we've been waiting for. Finally, you're here. We've been waiting for you. Our whole inventory is here. It's all yours, you know. You have the choice. Any choice, these cars are all yours. You just name it. We'll wash it, polish it up, vacuum it, clean it. It'll just be immaculate, you know. And we'll make the transaction super easy for you. No problem. In fact, it's free. For you, it's free. For you, it is free. You know, we're giving you this car. We want you driving our cars, you know. Hey, this is the, from snarky to get off my lot to, oh my God, we need you to be driving our cars. My God, we want everyone to see how great these cars are. You know, and we put you in the car you're driving, and people will say, wow, where do I get that car? You know, so, holy cow, any of you pick the car, you can drive for a while, trade it back in for another one, and whatever you want is yours. Whatever we have is yours. Free, please, please, we insist that you drive it. They can act that way too. Our attitudes can be like that too. Now, did we defeat somebody? Did we destroy somebody? Did we transcend someone? No. We simply realized through clarity what's going on. And simply we informed these actors and actresses, these attitudes, we informed them that, okay, I'm ready now for you to play this new role. This new role. And they say, sure. In fact, we enjoy this new role more, even more so than the old one, because the old one was, we didn't really want to be intimidating you, but you know, you told us that was our job, so we did it. So here we go. So now it's coming to light. What's coming to light? How is it possible to be transformed in this world, to have our attitudes transformed, to go from someone who just seems like they're so down and out, not deserving anything, to someone driving, you know, this solid gold, you know, white light, beautiful vehicle just driving, and people just say, wow, what a vehicle that is, you know, that's what? who was that before? Oh, somebody was just all depressed and sick and everything. No, no way, no way, no way, right? people can, but you have to tell them the truth of transformation. The truth of transformation is within us. It is nowhere else. We control our own transformation entirely. It has nothing to do with this, with time, space, form, or process. Absolutely nothing to do with it. It doesn't have anything to do with the stars or the cosmos or the universe or any of these so-called forces. Nada, nothing to do with it. It is entirely within us, within our own spirit and mind, okay, where we acknowledge the only problem we have is a continuity problem. There is no other problem. All attitudes I've had to intimidate me are working for me, have always been working for me, and I own them completely. They're not coming because I was born under some astrological sign. They're not coming because of my age, my gender, my race, my socialization, the roles I play. They're not becoming because of some cosmic waves or gravitation or cosmic forces. That has nothing to do with it, has never had anything to do with it. That's all an excuse. Fact is, I tried to separate from God. I tried to believe there were laws, separate laws that God didn't create, and I could live under those laws as if I was living in a separate kingdom. And because of that, I have a severe continuity fear, and because of that, I've tried to intimidate myself from not accepting reality as it is. I'm afraid of that because it's going to be so wonderful. I don't know how I can even cope with that. I feel like I don't have any being at all, because we're used to being as related to fear, actually. We think it. The time, space, process, and form, all this fear, you know, is a being. It's not. It's non-existent, actually. So our attitudes is entirely controlled by us. Our whole situation is controlled by us. It is not controlled by anything outside of us, supposedly outside of us, such as forces, cosmic forces. Nobody is under the spell of cosmic forces. Because there aren't any cosmic forces, actually. Not at all. Again, we're so creative that we're able to have appear to imply as if there were these forces. That is how creative we are. We are, as Jesus says, we are, this universe is a masterful creation of ours. An appearance, really. A masterful appearance that we have crafted it with. Such incredible creativity, masterfully crafted it, such that it implies that these forces are real. Time, space, process, form. It implies it. That's how this is like self-deception, but it's a masterful self-deception. But they do not exist whatsoever. Those forces have never existed. The only law of reality, of manifestation, is whatever we desire is. That's it. Whatever we desire is. That's the only law there is. So, the kingdom of heaven is within us. In other words, we control. We're totally responsible and totally control. Nothing is causing our situation. We are employing these attitudes purposefully, intentionally, to out of our continuity fear. As we evaporate the continuity fear, then we start realizing, hey, I'm the boss. I'm the one employing you. Great job. So when somebody there is harassing you and bullying you, instead of like freaking out, realize that you're the one who's employing these attitudes. And say, thanks so much. Great job. Wonderful. Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you so much. That's beautiful. Exactly what I asked you to do. Flawless, flawless. God bless. And now I'm going to give you a different role. You see? Now I'm going to give you to own it and say, okay, now I'm going to give you a different role. Now you're going to roll out the red carpet. In fact, wherever I go, the red carpet's going to be rolled out. And transformation will occur. The transformation will occur. Not because somehow the world did something to you, the cosmos did something to you. No, because you are really deserving to function as God created you to function, which is what every desired experience is. We're totally welcome, 100% perfectly welcome. Whatever we desire experience is, there's no forces over spirit, over God. There are no such forces. There's no time, space, process, or form whatsoever. And they don't exist. Never did. We don't have the power to create some sort of new laws of manifestation. Absolutely not. So this is the great good news. This is the gospel. All praise to Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. They're the ones that have been instrumental in helping clarify this. And of course, I've worked really hard, really diligently at this too. It takes a willing attitude, right, to look at this. It takes a willingness to look at this. So we're part of this transformation, and the advisors, you know, great advisors, Jesus and the Holy Spirit, have been great advisors. So all thanks to them, and thanks to everyone. We're all working on this together. It's tough for us here. This planet is a place which those who are very frightened find themselves here, because this planet gives us a very strong impression of time, space, process, and form, as if those were actually existed. Very strong impression of it. So you're not likely to find a whole lot of people here in this world who are really getting this, you know. Some do. But don't be discouraged just because everybody doesn't suddenly say, oh yeah, I get it. No, because this is, you know, this world tends to believe in external forces, whether they be personal, interpersonal, you know, world forces, nature forces, cosmic forces, all this stuff, thinking that they are molded. That's what has made them. That's as if their life has been made by the cosmos, by the universe. No, we made the universe. The universe didn't make us. The manifestation, the appearance of the universe, is something we have done. It didn't make us. So we're locked. Because of the continuity fear so severe, most people believe it can't be solved, because they think, no, I'm a product of this entire universe. How can I possibly overcome that? Well, simply by recognizing it's not true. There's nothing to overcome. There are no such forces. So we don't need to overcome the universe. We realize that there is no universe in terms of forces that have made us what we are. No, we are primary. God created us as being. You know, we're primary. Manifestation, appearance, is our experiencing. But we are fundamentally the pure awareness, the pure experiencer, you see. So we have it backwards here. We think that the appearances have made us. So it's tough for people. They can hear this, and something faint within them says, you know, I think I kind of feel this is true. And they go, wow. Like, wow. That's frightening. How do I overcome the universe? How do I transcend the universe? If I don't have the universe, what am I? What am I? Will I have any being, you know? Well, keep in mind that our creativity is such that if we want a universe to appear, it appears like that. We simply desire it, and it is. That's the creativity of love and light. It's infinite, measureless creativity. Whatever we desire spontaneously is. So it's just that we realize, oh, we're the ones. It's our creativity, our desire that rules. We're the boss. We're co-boss with God. It's not appearances. Appearances aren't the boss. All right. So again, The difficult part that would be helpful to say is that our creativity, the creativity that is one with what we are, is so perfect and flawless that when we ask this, we desire this creativity to give the impression that there were these laws of time, space, form, and process, and location, duration, when we asked for that, then there arose this universe that gives the impression that there are these forces, gives the impression of it, very flawlessly, beautifully, creatively, masterfully made appearance arising, spontaneously arising. And so we simply infer from all this, oh yeah, I mean, it's reasonable or plausible to infer that these laws exist. And that's what confuses us, okay? Because we hear the truth and we say, you know, I know that's true, and yet I'm still very confused. Very confused. Because we ask for this self-deception that infers and implies that these laws exist, even though they don't. That is why we need the Holy Spirit. That is why we need Jesus. But that's why we need the great teachers. They know better. They're not under the spell. And they say, look, with all love and compassion, we have to tell you the truth that these laws don't exist. But we understand that it seems plausible to infer that they do. Now, the problem is, in this world, is those who believe the continuity problem can't be resolved, they believe then they have no choice but to live under these laws. So if you say that these laws don't exist, they'll say you're insane. What they do is they say, well, it's not only is it plausible to infer, but anyone who does not infer must be completely insane, right? That's their position. And it seems like a very strong position, doesn't it? Because how do you prove that these laws don't exist to those who insist the continuity problem can't be resolved? There's no way to prove it. Only when we are willing to trust the Holy Spirit and ask for help, then the Holy Spirit says, don't worry, this is all illusion, a mirage, these laws are non-existent. But because of the continuity fear, will go gradually. So you cannot just prove to somebody that the laws don't exist, because that's not gradual. They have to go gradual. Is this the way? And you can understand now how severe the continuity fear is when you realize that none of these laws that we think formed our being have ever existed. So naturally we think that if we accept this fact and see it, we will be annihilated. We will cease to exist. But the fact is, when we recognize and see this, we realize the only law there is that whatever I desire to experience is. And so, whatever we desire to experience is. So no, we're not annihilated. But the fear is so severe that it has to be gradual. So people will still be stuck with these attitudes of mocking themselves and hating themselves and spitting on themselves and insisting that the body dies and they, you know, have all these problems. They'll still be stuck there because they have to go gradually. There's no other way. So the whole system is set up to go gradually. Now, if there's a transformation of someone, it's because they have taken this way of gradualism. I've definitely taken the way of gradualism. I call it the safe way. I call it the way that works. And you just evaporate. Just keep allowing yourself to have access to the top teachers, to the top inspiration, to the Holy Spirit, to the great teachings, to tremendous amount of effort and work and faith, and keep on doing that daily, every day. And the fear evaporates to such extent you begin to see, you know, oh yeah, forgiveness. Thank everyone, all these attitudes. Thank you for these snarky attitudes. I really appreciate it. Truly appreciate it. That is a wonderful job. and then an inner transformation to a new acting role, new attitudes, beatitudes, you see, wonderful attitudes of, I'm totally welcome. I'm totally welcome in reality. The red carpet is out, you see, transformation through gradualism. Transformation, ultimate transformation through gradualism. Bit by bit by bit by bit by bit by bit by bit. Every day. That's what works. That's what works. So if you really want to succeed, that's what works. And who doesn't want to succeed, actually? We really hate this imaginary life of being under control of all these forces, under control of time, under control of space, duration, location, under control of process, under control of form, as if all these constitute our being, that our being is formed by all these processes of constant appearing and disappearing, changing. Everything is under pressure. Everything is subject to shifting, disappearing. And we think our being is subject to disappearance, you know. So this hell is hell. We hate hell. We're just too afraid to get out of it. We just think the continuity problem can't be resolved. So we just say, you know what, I gotta learn to love hell. Most of the people in this world are trying to learn how to love hell, is what they're trying to do. They say, yeah, we just gotta unify. Yeah, we just all gotta, you know, be try and get along. Let's just all get along and let's try and make sure everybody has enough things here. Let's learn to love this place, you know. Love your Mother Earth. Love this place. Love hell. That's what most on this world are doing, because they don't have any, they don't believe that the continuity problem can be resolved. It seems overwhelmingly difficult. And granted, if you tried to do it yourself, it would certainly seem that way. But see, what happened with me is I hit rock bottom. I realized you can never learn to love hell. It's impossible. And I said, wow, this whole agenda is never going to work. And I said, what do? I don't have any other options. And then I said, are there any other options? Please help, help, help. Presence. I was aware of an intelligence, beautiful presence. I was aware of a beautiful presence. And subtle, just a subtlety, some beautiful subtlety, something just completely wonderfully positive, a positive subtlety that just said, no problem, I'll help you, and I assure you, you know, I will, the continuity problem will resolve, absolutely assure you. And I got this feeling of confidence. I said, wow, I got an ally. I have an ally who knows the way for sure. And then that confidence got translated into effort, you see. So you really, in order to even make the effort on the path, one has to have this root confidence that is going to work. And that really only comes from the Holy Spirit, from the grace of God, from being aware that the grace of God does exist within us. Otherwise, no, it's not. We will simply try to learn to love hell. That's the only other option we have. And when you try to learn to love hell, you unfortunately end up spiraling sort of, you know, downwards. It gets really weird, actually. And we certainly don't want that. You tend to become very fascist in the organization of society. Tend to go into sort of a slave-like domination, slave scenario, super organized, super bureaucratic, super law-making, demanding everybody, you know, monitoring everybody, demanding everybody do exactly what the bureaucratic laws insist upon. You end up in a hive-like mind, hive-like situation, dreadful situation where you feel like you must impose that upon everyone else. the religions you have are all are form only, law, ritual form, instead of the gospel of forgiveness, continuity, fear, Holy Spirit, forgiveness, inner transformation, clarity, contemplation, meditation, listening to the great sages, teachers, realization, love, freedom. See, that's the real religion. And of course, disciplining yourself so that you give yourself momentum. It's all about building up your momentum. The hive mind destroys momentum. Their only momentum is towards trying to learn to love hell. Okay, that's the momentum they're after. And that momentum is putting the control outside of themselves, as if the universe is somehow responsible for what they are. As if the universe is their home. Really, being is our home. Being is our home. All right? And the being naturally desires experiencing. So the being and the experiencing is our home. But we're never defined by what we're experiencing. What we are is never altered, changed, or defined by all our experiencing at all. So this world right now is going towards this hive mind, let's all learn to love hell agenda. And it should be in place in a couple years as far as really lockdown goes. So we have less than 2 years to truly absorb, you know, the gospel, the good news. But we certainly can do it. I mean, it's very simple, isn't it? It's actually very simple. It's accepting the continuity field. You have the continuity field, your only problem. Accepting that you have all the blocks you've put there yourself. Nobody put them there for you. There are no forces to put them there for you. You put them there to protect you from pure happiness because you want gradualism. So just own the whole situation. Own your situation. And then you will be free of this attempt to learn to love hell. You won't need it. You won't need it. Just own your situation. Own it. Nobody's doing anything to you. You're blocking yourself out of continuity fear. Forgive all the blocks, saying, thank you, block. Thank you so much for being there and blocking me, because that's what I felt I needed. Now, I don't need it anymore. So you can now roll out the red carpet for me. And that's what will happen. So some will go on the path of trying to learn how to learn to love hell, and others will go on the path to paradise. That's just how it is. That's always how it is. But don't worry, those who try to learn to love hell will never succeed. They will bottom out. They will recognize it's impossible. And then they'll say, help. And the Holy Spirit will be there for them too, just like it was for me. And they will then have the confidence. They say, you know what? I know the continuity fear can't be resolved. I know it. And from that point on, the path opens up for them, you see. So everybody will be saved. Everybody will be saved. No matter how much they try to learn to love hell, they will still be saved, absolutely. So this is also the great good news. Now let's see if anything else comes up to share here. So we don't need to pay attention to what happens in the world. We know what's happening. The people either trying to learn to love hell, or they're owning their situation, their continuity fear, as the only problem they have, in accepting the grace of God, the Holy Spirit, in subtle miracles helping them evaporate that continuity fear. They're owning the blocks that they have. See? That's all the wars, the plagues, all the... It doesn't matter. We already know what that's about, fundamentally. And since we're not about that, you know, we don't have to focus on it. We don't have to focus on it. We're about owning the situation that we're in, owning our attitudes. That's what we're about. And thanking our attitudes and forgiving ourselves. Forgiving our attitudes, saying, hey, not only forgiving, but loving our attitudes. Say, thank you so much for having such a terrible attitude and blocking me all this time. That is, you know, wonderful, great job. And really, you will reach this point of, like, really deep felt gratitude and forgiveness for this. And you will have forgiven yourself, you see. Forgiveness is really self-forgiveness, forgiving yourself. This is what A Course in Miracles focused on. This is what Jesus focuses on, rightly so. Forgive yourself. It's always forgiving yourself, not forgiving someone else. No one's ever done anything to you that you didn't desire to experience. That your own attitudes, you're entirely responsible for how you feel and your attitudes. So self-forgiveness is the only forgiveness there is. Okay, self-forgiveness is the only forgiveness there is. Self-forgiveness. So, we either practicing self-damnation or self-forgiveness. One is the attempt to, self-damnation is actually the attempt to learn to love hell and say, we love hell so much we're staying here forever. We're going to keep believing that there are these laws of time, space, process, and form. Self-forgiveness is to realize there have never been any of these laws. But that's not my problem. My problem is the continuity fear. And I've been blocking myself from awareness of this because I'm afraid of pure happiness. So all this blockage is my own blockage. I've been doing it to myself. Nobody's done it to me. Self-forgiveness leads to paradise. Self-forgiveness leads to paradise. Paradise is really is as far as you can go with still maintaining some sense of form, okay? And then from there, it's ultimately formless, okay, ultimately. But that's beyond anything we need to even consider at this point. we're a ways away from that. Our goal is to take the necessary steps to get to paradise, actually, which is the death-free realm, which is the realm that is totally apparent. There's just one force, and that's the force of love and living light that we're desiring. And that love and living light is sustaining all appearance there flawlessly, beautifully, perfectly, without any effort on our part whatsoever. There's not a trace of any other force, and it's completely apparent there are no other forces. And then once we really experience that in a context of familiar appearances, like a world, then we realize, wow, we can start practicing our true creativity. And then gradually we get into this where we don't even need to imagine that we are, you know, a body or there's some set world or anything. Everything is flowing. It's just a dynamic of ever beautiful flowing glory. You know, but that's something we gradually practice on. And we don't need to get ahead of ourselves. We're focusing that, you know, on forgiveness, self-forgiveness. And that brings about a transformation. What is that transformation? The red carpet is rolled out for us. We feel all of life becomes a red carpet experience. You know, our attitudes treat us like we're the greatest celebrity ever, like we're the most wonderful being ever, that we're just like perfect being. Because we are perfect being. All is perfect being. But our attitudes now are treating us this way, you see. As long as we think we need attitudes, you see, ultimately we don't even need any attitudes. But because we're continuity issue, we're used to attitudes, we transform our attitudes into now. Our attitudes are just treating us like we're perfect being. And then we start realizing we are perfect being. We are. Whatever we desire to experience is, that's the law, only law there is. So take this gospel to heart, not to the head, so to speak. Meaning, take the wholeness, the totality of it, okay? And not the parsing of it, not the parsing of it. Not the fragmenting of it, the cataloging of it, the dissecting of it. Don't dissect it. It's an entire holistic vision, isn't it? It all rings true. Just let that ringing, that vibrant ringing, just let it resonate. Just let it resonate. All right, very great. And let the self-forgiveness and attitudinal transformation, let it begin. Let it begin with us. All right. Many blessings, everybody. That's it.